Yeah.
Good luck,
oh,
and
yeah.
That's going to be good.
Oh,
timing
you're golden,
is good on that.
For sure. But look at this tent map behind me, you guys. It's insane right now. We've got this line of demarcation, if you will, all across the midsection of the country from Chicagoland, where it's 59, all the way south and west toward El Paso, Texas. On the other side of that, it is downright brutal now as Arctic air continues oozing south, but it has been confined here, 22 below at Butte, Denver now at zero, and we're 5 at Bismarck, Minneapolis, 20. Flip side of things, a little more tolerable. More pleasant, a little more friendly, shall we say, in the temp department. Around here in Orlando, it's 67 currently, but we are looking good. You can see all the weather elements now, all these fronts kind of straddled across the nation. Notice this arced kind of nature to it as the clouds and some rainfall rush up into the upper Midwest. And then the other side of that, it's all snow and that ice storm Amy mentioned approaching portions of Wisconsin and the southern section of Minnesota. And you can see how that bends out that away. Back through here, we are null and void. Just an increase in clouds from time to time. It's big high pressure marching steadily back out west toward the state of Florida, giving us good looking temperatures this morning, solid 60s and 70s. And I tell you, this time of year, it is all about the winds. The wind direction has been calling the shots day in, day out. We're southeasterly again down at the Cape and out at Melbourne, running much warmer down there and sustained now at 13. There'll be some gusts probably in the range of 15 to 20 today. So I'd call it like locally breezy for some of us, warm and humid, mixed skies, some sun, some clouds, 84 by 2. We're in the 80s for the drive home at 5. Our pollen count today is up. It comes down a little bit on the back end of the week. It's oak and wild grasses and that kind of stuff this time of year. And again, another look here for you shows you the big map. I want to take you a little bit tighter now and take you down in the central Florida. You can really see a lot of that cloud cover brewing up over the Bahamas and slowly beginning to shuffle our way. So essentially this mix of sudden clouds coming on back in pretty strong. Mid-upper levels of the atmosphere as we scan it and analyze that, showing us a lot of dry air. So we've taken the rain chances out of the equation through midweek. By Thursday, still at about zero. By the weekend, some of the modeling kind of hemming and hawing over maybe a few raindrops kind of here and there, but even then, I'm not going to bite just yet, so we'll leave it dry for your Saturday and Sunday. So for Seminole County today, a nice day today, blended skies, sun and clouds, solid 80s for highs, and the same can be found at County South through Orange, Orlando Metroplex, no issues. We'll call it solid mid-80s, modeling hinting at a much warmer scenario over southwestern Orange County, and they're in the upper 80s. Brevard, again, this speaks for itself. A lot of warmth in play with solid 80s and blended skies. Sun and clouds for you on the day, and we'll keep things dry. Next 7, 80s knocking on the door. Someone's going to let them in, that's for sure. Solid mid-80s for you through midweek. We'll see the 60s through the overnight. No chance of rain, just toasty temps abound all the way through Sunday into next Monday. That's your forecast. Here's Kristen now with Live Drive. Good morning.